Welcome, welcome to the third quarter podcast show. And this is part two of healthy relationships because we ain't quite. Me and Five Star felt like we ain't quite really get to the nitty gritty on the first one. No. So we doing a part two. You know, we always do a part two. Usually we do.
On important topics. Yeah,
important topics. Yeah. Important topics. And, you know, we run a man back. Let's thank one of our sponsors, Very Detroit.
VeryDetroit.com.
There you go. Just DL.
Yo.
DL, show. Come on, tell it.
Hey, VeryDetroit.com. Check them out. 6:90 a.m. every 11 a.m. to noon on Friday.
Noon on Friday.
11 a.m. to noon on Friday.
Randy's going to come fix Five Star.
Yeah. Talking all this.
We can tell she didn't play with video games growing up.
Pac-Man.
Pac-Man, Atari. That was just a stick. So that one, you just push one red button.
I prefer Ms. Pac-Man, personally. I was Ms. Pac-Man guy. Yeah, the boards changed.
I like all of them. Ms. Pac-Man was a lot of boards.
Yeah. I enjoyed it.
Especially the big game. They got a place downtown where they sell pizzas and all that old, and they got all the old games in there. Mm-hmm.
Pop-Off World.
I think it's two of them, but yeah, I got to take my son down there because he don't appreciate old stuff.
I straight up saw a Black Sabbath cover band there.
What?
At Pop-Off World. Yeah, it's a chameleon. I've DJed there. They've seen cover bands, whatever. Get some pizza, hang out. They have poetry, everything. Karaoke.
I need to be there. I love poetry.
Oh, above Checker Bar, Pop-Off World. You're welcome, Tim.
Oh, yeah.
Tim's the owner, so I just gave him a free, you know.
Oh, nothing. Hey. I need some tokens.
That's it.
I need a token. And we have this lovely guest in today.
Good afternoon.
Introduce yourself. Good say afternoon. Whatever you like to say.
Dorma Magruder, DormaMagruder.com, and I am privileged to be in the company of three wonderful people, two whom I've interacted with last week. The show was wonderful. Another plug for Very Detroit, and to be in the presence of the Honorable Kasim. Nice to meet you, and I'm here to talk to contribute to the conversation on healthy relationships because unfortunately I know about them because I went through a really, really bad one, more than one, but it's okay. And that's the operative phrase. I went through it. Okay?
Yes.
It was too long, but yes. I came through it, should I say.
Yes.
And we live and we learn. And
you got to learn from your mistakes.
Yes.
You got to learn from your anger. You got to learn from your pain and you have to move on.
Absolutely.
Because once you go on, the world's still turning.
The world is still turning. Time is still marching on.
Yes.
And no one stopped for me to make that mistake, and no one stopped for me to correct it. But I've learned, and it's okay.
That's it.
It's made me better, and it's helping other people because.
Yes.
And as a result of that, Norma, you've written a book. And
I have published a book, One Bad Decision. One Bad Decision put me
One Bad Decision.
One
That's her
term.
Book.
Bad Decision.
One Bad Decision.
One Bad Decision put me in
Me, hell. I have more than one. And so I had to learn right shit multiple
Most
times.
And you live to tell the tale.
I'm here today. And that's why I'm meeting wonderful people in my new life.
Okay.
I call it my new life.
Yes.
Yeah.
And we have to recognize that every day we wake up, that's another day to create more for that new life.
Yes. And I feel like every last one of us has a responsibility on this planet to make it better.
Yes, we do. Because we are giving in exchange for this day. We're given a bill at midnight for this day.
Yes.
What have we given in exchange for it? Yeah. How productive have we been? Who have we served? Who have we helped? And for relationship purposes, how much have we loved us? Because it starts with us. If I love me enough, I'm not going to let you do just anything to me.
I agree.
Thank you.
Well said.
Thank you. I'm glad I had to say that today. Today's topic is healthy relationships, part two.
And we're going to start with what you just said.
Yes, we are.
I believe that if you don't know yourself, then you're definitely not ready to get into a relationship. I mean, you have to really know yourself, know what you want, know what your faults are. You have to do that introspection. That is just so important. And a lot of folks these days, they don't do that.
No,
they have
don't.
A failed relationship. Then they feel that as time has passed, you know, maybe a year or so, that they're ready to get back out there and they didn't do any work. And then they create another mess. And then they wonder why they don't have a healthy relationship.
Yes. And they want to make the next person pay for what the first one did.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And yeah, that isn't fair. Mm-hmm. And also, in knowing, to piggyback on what you just said, five star, mm-hmm. when you are talking about what you want and who you are, I have a couple of philosophies on that. First of all, as women and men, we have to judge ourselves based on our worth and our value, not our cost. Our cost is our hair, our nails, mm-hmm. our haircut, our clothes, our cars, our homes. That's our cost. Our value is our heart, our mind, our wisdom, our knowledge. What have we learned?
Is part of that value time?
Absolutely. Yes.
The most precious gift you can
have. And it's the only thing you can't get more of.
Talking about your time.
I always talk about DL. I always talk about my time.
And time is the only thing you can't get. We can make more money. We can get another partner. We can get it. But we can't make any more time.
Mm-hmm.
And also, in conjunction with that, you have to know what you don't want. Even if you don't know everything that you do want, you have to recognize what you don't want. If you want someone to be with you a lot, then when someone in the beginning of the relationship, they've always got other things to do and they can only see you once every couple of weeks, hey, then that's not the one for you.
Absolutely.
Because you know what you don't want.
It's the cost of doing business.
That's,
I mean, in all reality, you got to find a partner that's willing to be a part of it and pay the cost.
Yes.
And I believe that the don't wants help you define what you do want.
Very clearly. Yes, they do. Yes, they do. If you want a person... I like to cook and I like to go out, okay, but I'm not a quote unquote partier kind of person. But if that's what you want to do, we can do that every now and then. But we can't do it every night. My heart and my mind and my blood pressure won't take that every night. And if we're always in a loud space around a whole lot of people, when are we spending time mm-hmm. to get to know one another?
That quality time.
And when are we spending time to enhance one another? Because if you're building a business, maybe there is something that I can do to help. Mm-hmm. Maybe I know someone who can help. If not with funding, maybe with a connection or something. Well, if I'm building a business, you may know. But if all we do is just hang out and have a good time and we don't ever get to the nitty gritty, I'm telling my age.
You don't have
certain
to.
Things. I don't mind. I'm
61. I love saying I'm 50.
I don't mind. I'm 61.
I love saying
I'm 61
that.
And I'm grateful I don't look it, so they tell me. But
exactly.
Anyway, but you know, we've got to know what's important, and mm-hmm. and a large part of that, if education means a lot, then you want someone who's well spoken, who is well, okay. And then we also have to delve into why are certain things important. Is it important that it's not important what kind of car he drives or what kind of car she drives? What drives them? That's what's most important, okay?
That's right.
And when we can determine that, we can go a lot further and make a lot more progress in terms of relationship. If you are a quote-unquote spiritual person and you like going to church, don't pick somebody who goes to church once a year. That's not going to work for you.
Right.
And what you get is what you've got. You're not going to change them in midstream.
Okay.
Yes,
okay.
Please say that again.
What you get is what you've got. We can get better. And we can maybe do things a little bit differently, but essentially what you get in the beginning, that's what you're going to have 10 years down the line.
Okay.
So,
and that's a problem for most women.
And that
they
can
don't
be a
understand
problem.
That.
Well, mama raised them. You can't re-raise them.
Mm-hmm. You can't re-raise mm-hmm. them, and we're all grown.
Mm-hmm. Okay. That's Let it. Me introduce this guy right here.
Good afternoon. How are you?
Look at that. Look at that. You know what I'm saying? Look at that. Look at there. Now, me and this guy, we go back 40
like
years.
Like seats.
Oh, we, when I say we go back, and let me tell you why he here. We done fell out a couple of times. But because of the love between our families and the love that me and him have between each other, we still friends. Okay. We was mad at each other. We ain't talked for a while.
There's nothing wrong with
conflict. But because of the love, the one thing that me and this dude have is love. We can get out. We don't have to talk. One time, we ain't talked for like 4 or 5 years. But we can apologize. We can talk. And that's the reason why I love this dude right here. Because this dude made me a better me. He made Cassine who Cassine is today. And introduce yourself.
Blessings, everybody. I'm Pastor Mo. I do my handle. I say I'm Pastor Mo, a.k.a. the street preacher, a.k.a. the street sweeper, AKA my brother and sister's keeper. What up, though?
All right.
So, pleasure to meet everybody. I know this young lady right here. She's an author and a book writer, an entrepreneur. Excellent.
Thank you.
I am Maurice L. Hartwicks, my name. Pastor Mo is what I go by today. I'm here on behalf of my great brother and friend, Kasim. And Kasim told a lot of truth. He's a very upfront, as you know, honest person. And it's just a blessing to see my friend evolve to the man that he is today. You know, he said I teach him, but in many ways he's taught me through the years. We come through the trenches of the city of Detroit. We two East Side boys who was good. We were good young men, but just in the wrong environment. You know what that's like, going the wrong way. And, you know, had good mothers, but no fathers. And we was the product of not having fathers present. And that propelled us to become good fathers and better men. And it bonded our friendship because he taught me how to be a better dad, one of the best dads in this world to his son. Who's disabled, but who is now able because of he taught him how to be able. And as a kid, as a baby, I watched him nourish this baby, and it taught me how the way he would dress him, the way he would just put extra care into his son. It really, really propelled my mind to understand life is better. We got to grow up. I had to grow up quick, amen. And so this is my friend, my brother. Over 30 years, we had some issues over time. Cause we were just young. we both was arrogant as hell, you know, just doing our own thing. And we was just, all our friends, we was just like, you know, rough, go up the rough side of the mountain. And we just wanted to, we were just really in fear of losing each other, fear of competition, petty competition. We were pushing and fighting and just scraping and scrapping. And a lot of our friendship didn't last, but his and I withstood the test of time. And I always say, a friend, I won't know you my friend until we have a disagreement, until we have an ought. If you my ought, you my friend after the ought, then you my brother. But if I can't get past the ought with you, if I can't offend you one, two times and be wrong or right, then you don't really love me. Because family fall out all the time, right? Uh-huh. And we are family. So we had times we just separated and... But we always sit back and we always would shut our mouth. Other folk would talk about us. We would shut our mouth because you know why? We knew we loved each other. We were mad at each other, but we knew we loved each other. So some things we just would not say or wouldn't go into. So that's my brother.
And that's a reason why I got this guy here to talk about healthy relationships. Because it go beyond
romance.
Just...
Yeah. Yes, it does.
You're just talking about a healthy relationship right there,
yeah.
Man.
Yeah.
I mean, it doesn't have to be.
And that's why I asked him to come here. I'm glad he didn't keep going because he probably would have made me cry. I haven't cried so much in my 40s, you know, now. But, you know, but this is my co-host, Five Star.
Bless
this is DL. I asked DL to come back because DL said some shit on the last show. I've been writing some. I listened to the show and I wrote some of the shit down that he was saying, especially that one, Dreams Are Sexy.
Yeah.
That really stuck with me.
He looks highly intelligent.
I appreciate it.
No, he is fucking intelligent. And you already know her. So we got to get into this. We got to get into this healthy relationship because you know what? I am tired of fucking being single.
Hey.
I'm tired.
This is the craziest thing. I got to talk about that because this is one of the craziest things I ever seen in my life. This guy being single. Because I know growing up, it was three of us, three amigos, me, him, and another friend named Locke. And so this is what the girls were saying.
This is one of those that you were telling me
about? Yeah, this is the one.
See, we get closer and closer. see what I'm saying?
Yeah, see, it would be the girls were like, they would like us, right? We always had an issue with women, all of us, because it was more or less, we couldn't get them, we'd get them above of us. And they would say, you know, they would say, we like Locke, we like him. And they would say, this one here, me, it's going to be something sexual with him. So we want to marry him, though. Yeah. They always liked to wanted to marry this man. So I do not, for the life of me, understand how is he still single when all the girls like him.
Because very he intelligent, knows what he good looking guy, and what he doesn't want.
He's too real for
and
the
knows
game.
What he's bringing to the table and what he but is it, leaving off the
but
table.
But I don't understand why it should be 10 of them lined up.
Don't matter. If 11 isn't there, then
I'm going to look deeper. Yeah. This is a good guy. Like, mm-hmm. and then how he has evolved. Like, because my friend wasn't always the nicest guy in the world to be a part of.
No, I was an asshole.
He had, listen, my friend had the worstest mouth to a woman. And I would say, Cassine, don't say that, dog. Mm-hmm. No, he's a snap, you know. This mouth just did not care. Just no filter.
Oh,
I mean, he would not care. So I saw this man move from that to the most compassionate person, the most loving, endearing, thoughtful, wanting to date. Listen, he told women, I don't even want to have sex with you. I'm like, huh? This guy, we call him Shoe. His name was Shoe. His name was the degenerate. He was just talking so far with women with sex and stuff. He was like, I don't want to have sex with them. I want to get to know them. Well. I'm like, who just snatched my friend and brought somebody else back down here to earth? He had changed. He had, you know, God, he just changed. Then he found God in his life. It elevated it. So I don't understand how they wanted him so bad. He was the degenerate. Mm-hmm. And now he's this giant man of a God. And I guess it's just a lot of women out here ain't got their stuff together, though. Because he ain't going to take anything, though. Don't think about him.
No.
When he ain't putting up with anything.
Yeah.
You do not.
Oh, I know one of the big things he's not going to put up with, if any, I told a couple of females already, don't talk to me. You don't know him. I know him. If you ain't sincere about getting to know his son and being a nurturer, keep it moving. You ain't gonna make it. I tell all of them, I see it coming. Come in here, you can come in here as fine as you wanna come in here with an hourglass shape and the behind big as this building. If you don't get to know his son, for real,
I know.
And become a nurturer, you can keep it moving. You're gonna be out of there in less than 30 days.
Well, we were just talking about that. He knows what he wants.
Part of her. So, Five Star, you got something.
Well, just to add to that, what we were saying,
yes.
You have to know what you want.
Yes.
A lot of times my friends, when they're single, I was married and they were single, and I would always tell them, hey, why don't you list 100 qualities that you want in a man? And they're like, 100 qualities? I'm like, yeah, 100 qualities, and then break that down to 10 qualities and to the top 10 that you want. And from there, these are the things that you look for. And two of the girls did that, and they're in a healthy relationship right now.
And look at what you... Now, I've never been married, and that's a whole saga, but I have a very good idea of what I do and don't want. Even at, at 61, do I feel like it's too late? No.
No.
But
no.
I also know that at 61, what I'm not bringing to the table and what I am bringing to the table. Mm-hmm. And because I am 28 karat gold, that's what I want.
Heavy.
Exactly. Well,
you got to be able to communicate that too.
And that's what I've got to be able to communicate.
A lot of motherfuckers ain't ready to receive that.
If they're not ready to receive it, that's not my problem.
Yeah.
But you can pick that up soon. You can pick that up in the first conversation or two. Because it's not about the money and yes, that's very important. But what are you, okay, like you're talking about with your son, all right? What else is there that is so important? Because if there's a son, then there are other things about you that we have to get to know, and we have to be willing to appreciate your deal breakers and your deal makers. Yeah. And I have to be willing to extend mine. And we've got to know that and be clear about that up front, because it saves a whole lot of time. Life is too short. Okay, so we can't spend 2-3 years, or like you said, 30 days. We can't spend that kind of time wondering. And you've got to love yourself enough.
That's
okay. You've got to love yourself enough. That's how I got into that relationship, because I did not love me enough. I felt like, as well as I was doing successful business, successful entrepreneur, beautiful car, lavishly furnished apartment, with all of those things that I was doing, I did not feel like I needed a man to complete me. I felt like I needed him, because he convinced me that I needed him. and that I was not good enough without him. And when you let a person get your mind, that is how they get you. That's how Jim Jones got those people in Guyana. He got their minds. And when you get a person's mind, you don't have to worry about anything else. So guard that, protect that, love that, and love you. Know what you want and what you don't want. Okay, you know what? I could eat this and I could eat that. Love your body enough. You know what? I don't have to have the whole thing right now. I can have a little bit. Because this is the only house you're going to live in.
I had to learn the hard way how to fall in love with me. And every day I hear something like when DL was on the show, he blew me the fuck away.
Can we talk about the dreams of sexy before we leave?
All day long.
He blew me away with he came on here with his honesty and everything up front.
That's the only way I know.
And you know what I'm saying? I didn't have guests on this show before.
Okay.
Where it take them the second show to open up.
All right.
I don't have to wait to open up. He know. I open the fuck up immediately.
I thought that's why we're here.
I have yes. nothing to be ashamed for.
Okay.
Because I already been forgiven. Forgiven.
That's it. Starts with you.
I already, and once I'm insured with that, I hear like you talking, I hear him talking, I hear it. I even fast. We talk all the time, and I'm still learning how to better myself.
That's important, but we have to learn how to better ourselves until we leave here. This is the only life that we get, all right, as far as we know. And what are we going to do with it? What is the best that I can do with it?
Right.
How much have I learned today? Did I learn something new on my computer today? Did I learn some new words today? Did I learn a new program today? Did I read another book today? What did I do to make Dorma better? Never mind how I'm trying to make you better since we're in a relationship. Yeah. Never mind how I'm trying to make everybody. What did I do to make me better? Because I love me and because I want to contribute something serious to the planet and to those around me. What have I done to make me better? So my first relationship is with me and with God. And once that works, then we can talk about the rest.
Well, I mean, we are all students and teachers, and I've said it many times. If I wanted a robot, I'd make one. I want somebody to bring something to the table. Show me your passions. Show me your dreams. Show me what you want from life, because we're going to walk together in this. It's not 10 steps behind. It's together.
Right. And it doesn't have to be perfect, because it's not going to be. And we don't have to do every single thing together. I don't think anybody in their right mind wants somebody around them all the time, even when we are in love. But those basic things.
I would love somebody to be around me all the time.
No.
You're connected through that.
One of my favorite
quotes. I went through that. I would love. I would love to be with some.
People need a long time.
You do.
No. The little break I just need is just to go to the shower.
Well, let me tell you, my favorite quote is by Khalil Gibran, and he states that there should be spaces in your togetherness. So when that person is off doing them, they're getting stimulated.
Okay, when you go to the barbershop and I go to the hair salon.
Exactly.
I understand that, but I've been single for 2 damn long.
You start to say something else.
The fuck up. And I don't mind whoever wants to be. My best value to me is my time. He know that. If I'm giving my time to you after everything else that I'm dealing with, it's value.
Okay.
He know that. I just can't never find nobody that understand that shit.
Well, they don't love themselves enough, and maybe they're not confident enough in themselves to do that or to accept that. You also have to recognize that a lot of people have been beaten up and battered by life for so long that it has become their normal, as opposed to accepting the good and the new and the best as being a new normal. A lot of people can't get to that, and maybe that's why. But you said that you and God know each other. You said
that you
are good with you. You said, so I am a strong believer, not religious, but spiritual. I'm a strong believer in the power of prayer. I dare you to seriously pray and ask God to let the right one come and watch her show up. And
come
you
on,
won't
Ma.
Be able to get rid of her, and you won't want to get rid of her. Did I lie, Pastor?
Hey.
It may not be today. It may not be tomorrow.
Yeah, well, that's definitely value in faith, speaking words of affirmation for what you believe in for, and for God to show, you know, for you to put a mandate on things spiritually, because you know we can move mountains with our words. Our words start wars. Our words is very powerful. You know, however, I think there have to be some steps taken, some measures made. I think I've been married 20 years. I don't know nothing about this dating now, but I'm a kind of a fan as a pastor and as one who counsels people. I'm a fan of this online dating stuff. I think it cuts out a lot of time and my opinion is that you can find out somebody's qualifications. People are finding love at 40 and 50 and falling head over heels because they are now settled. And I think, I'm going to say this too, I think black men, we have a huge issue when it comes to love, because and the issue starts from our younger years. Black men never had a chance to, and she said, why he don't love me? He don't even love himself. He don't even know himself. Black men have set in the cut, you know, found the pretty girl in the hood. We have had premarital sex, knocked her up, and we get the little house and the little apartment with her, and we go from mama's house, baby mama's house. And they never had a chance to be grown on their own and doing well, to get to know themselves, to have a dating process. They just go from, you know, from house to house, from mama house to this mama house, and they never get a chance to really find out who they are. And so they never going to be in love or know how to love when they never been nurtured themselves, no father there, and they never had a time to get to really know themselves to work those things out. And in our culture, that's how we grew up. And so you find yourself, you know, waiting until you're 40 and 50 to really realize that, many times you see these people out here like, well, I live at. You see a lot of couples that's now divorcing that after the kids are in high school, graduate, they're getting divorced quick because they realize that we don't have nothing in common. Well, you've been with her for 20 years, 25 years, but you met her because she was pretty and had pretty hair. Didn't know nothing about her qualifications or who she was. You're a reader, she's not. She's outdoors, you're not. You have nothing in common with this person. But she was cute and you had a baby, right? Yeah. So now we got to go back to the dating line to figure out, hey, you're a reader, I'm a reader. You avid reader, we like to go hiking. Hey, we can now spend time. This works because now we both like to work, you know. You find out the things that you can live with and can't live with. That's a good start, right? And then you can find out if they're not on there catfishing or whatever. But,
well, you hit the nail on the head. Common interests. Common yes. interests is yeah, where it's interest. At, man. Because at the end word. Of the day, looks is just skin deep. Yeah. It's your personality and what you're interested in and what can you do together. That's positive. And as far as I'm concerned, healthy relationships is anything where people are happy. If you got two people that are happy, they're in a healthy relationship. And that could be with your family, with your boss, with your coworkers, with your friends. I mean, it's all healthy relationships. It's all, I mean, mm-hmm. we are pack animals. Mm-hmm. So we are part yeah. of this together.
Right. I don't think healthy can even be possible for anything healthy when you haven't dealt with the illnesses or the ills in yourself. Childhood issues. You know, people have had trauma in their life, drama and trauma, then you ask them, have you ever had counseling? Have you ever sat down and had those issues worked out, talked about, and they never. So this is why he's so angry. This is why he can't talk to you. And this is why she runs to her parents and tell them everything. She never got off the breast, off the nipple. So it's people have never really dealt with their childhood issues.
And as a girl.
And it's an issue now in relationships.
It is. As a girl, who came from a family of girls, everything was not only what happens in the house stays in the house. That's one big problem in our culture. Mm-hmm. Whatever happens in the house stays in the house. We didn't have that luxury of counseling for a long time. But as a girl who grew up in a house full of girls, you were not permitted, you know, it was understood that you were going to, I was the oddball, that you were going to get married and move and live with whomever. And so not only did you as a man not have the opportunity to get to know you, we didn't have that opportunity to know you and to know ourselves. And sometimes our unhealthy relationships started within our families because whatever your mother or your father said, that was law. right or wrong, good or bad, no matter which adult lied on you, no matter which teacher lied on you.
Right.
So you've got unhealthy relationships starting within the house. So here is this excuse and this man who's willing to take you out of that unhealthy situation. Yes, I am going. Not realizing that you've got an open cancer wound that has been festering for 15, 20 years. So you don't know anything. You haven't been able to be healthy within you.
Yeah, you can see it play out with Michael Jackson's life. It's a perfect example.
Oh,
this young, beautiful kid was mentally, physically, verbally abused, and forced to be a grown up as a child. That never got dealt with because he had to go perform, and because of his performance, he ended up self-medicating himself to cope with life. Then it went so far as to medicate himself with all these wonderful things that you only could dream of. And so now I'm going to live in my dream, in my bubble, and now I'm going to become a child and be Peter Pan again. Got him in trouble with these children.
Mm-hmm.
He then went from self-medication to finding a doctor who can put him to sleep.
And that was and all he wanted was to sleep.
No, that's how he died. He died a tragic end, mm-hmm. stemming from back from him just childhood, never dealing with those issues correctly.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I got a question. Is compromising part of a healthy relationship?
Yes, well, on absolutely. Certain things.
Yeah, as long as it's a
absolutely.
Positive compromise.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, compromise is life.
Yeah, when I counsel, because you said a great word, I give people the three C's, four C's. Make sure I remember. I know mm-hmm. I give them communication,
mm-hmm.
compromise, Lord Jesus.
Compassion.
Compassion. And in Christ. I said, with those four, if you don't have communication, you don't compromise, you're not compassionate, and you don't have God, you're not going to make it. Those four take you a long way. I counsel with those four C's.
Okay, but most people get compromising with and settling confused.
With who?
So yes. Being settling for something.
Settling okay. for something settling
less. Less than what they want.
Okay.
So what's the difference?
Well, you know, compromising is to me the essence of when you're talking about the union of two becoming one.
Mm-hmm.
And it was said in this wrong thought process to say that the two come together and they make each other whole and become one. That's not possible. You're not supposed to come half and half make whole. That's never going to work.
Mm-hmm.
Two wholes become one. Well, how does two wholes become one? Well, you come to the table whole, full,
mm-hmm.
sure of yourself, confident in who you are, already complete. She don't complete you, you don't complete her. Christ completes you. What you do is you deduce yourself to have, how's that? The Bible says, I consider you better than myself. So my life is like what he said, I'm ready to be married, so I'm going to consider my significant other, I'm going to make sure that you eat first. You're taking care of your gas in your car. I'm going to do things. I'm going to compromise that I'm not going to always watch my TV show. I want to watch sports, but I'm going to watch a love movie with you because you love that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to deduce myself and give up and put you ahead of me. Now watch this. How it works is the other partner is supposed to be doing the same thing.
I give you a Super Bowl party.
Doing
for
it right.
Friends.
And guess what?
Exactly.
Guess who doesn't lose? Nobody.
Nobody loses.
But when you say me, 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 and this is where it's supposed to be, somebody going to lose in that thing.
Mm-hmm.
Probably both of you.
Okay, so what's settling, though?
What's settling?
When you mm-hmm. settle, what
settling.
Is that? An
okay,
example of that.
You're handsome, you're kind, and all of that, but you don't want to work. You don't want to hold a job. You don't want. But I'm going to settle for you because
fake
I'm
potential.
Making an, yeah.
Well, to me, settling is in negative context and compromise is in positive. So just right off the bat, it's like the line
mm-hmm.
in the sand. Settling, to me, sounds negative. Or
yeah.
compromise sounds positive.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Settling sounds like that you're not happy or complete in that agreement.
Or you just tired.
You're just
desperate.
You're going along with something.
Yeah.
You know,
to get
I
along.
I like the way you put it. You said that... that guy smelled Tyrone.
There is
smelled the perfume.
The perfume that women wear that men don't wear, but men can smell on women. And as women, we can't even smell it on each other. And the way he got me is he smelled my perfume, and the perfume I was wearing was the perfume of desperation.
I like that. There it is. I like that.
Okay. I gotta ask DL, Mo, Pastor Mo. I gotta ask y'all something. In a healthy relationship, do each other, you know, man or woman, whatever it can be, encourage each other to be better without even telling them?
Yes.
Sounds like support.
Yes.
Exactly. Without even telling them, like, I don't have to, but the energy, the positive energy that they give off to make me feel good makes me go out and want to conquer the world.
Mm-hmm. So that's inspiration.
Yeah.
It inspires you.
Yeah. And so, yeah.
What's the question again?
It was like a question, a statement. But
can you encourage someone without telling them to be
without even saying, I need you to do this, to do that. Actions that's and the huge. Way no, I treat no, and respect
huge.
You.
That's
will
huge.
That make you? Go
that's huge.
Yeah,
that's,
yeah. That, make that woman so, because I know what I can do for you.
That's so huge when the relationship is when you have to verbalize everything to somebody, like you're raising a kid again.
Yeah.
Are you ready for a relationship for real? Because, no, seriously, because you know what to do when it's something that you want.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And that's the whole thing about consideration and compassion, consideration, what I consider you other than just myself in this situation.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, to make sure that you're set. I'm gonna make sure you're set. I'm not set till you're set.
Uh-huh.
And that doesn't take me having to tell you. You should know, you should want to get to know me. And then once you get to know me,
I know what
begin
to
operate on me in that love language.
Sounds like lead by example, right?
Yeah. Yes.
That's
exactly.
It.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. And you just mentioned love language.
Yes.
I believe in that. Oh,
absolutely.
My goodness.
Uh-huh. Absolutely. What's your love language?
Oh, mine are is gifts.
Yeah, mine's affirmation and gifts.
Who giving?
Affirmation and gifts.
You giving or you receiving?
No, I'm receiving. Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
I'm receiving.
It is. That's how I feel.
Yeah, I think mine's is
what is he supposed to feel?
I don't know. It depends on his love language.
Well, how do you communicate your love?
Yeah.
How do you communicate your love language?
Because mine's
that's
is
what
both.
He's asking.
Mine's giving both ways. And I like you, I'm going to give you a gift. I'm not going to just, I may not say all the words. I'm going to do something nice for people I like. I try to always do something, be there for them in some kind of huge way. So mine is giving as well.
Okay. Not necessarily giving, but mine is encouragement, words of encouragement, things like that.
Mm-hmm.
Mine is giving, but mine is giving personal stuff because my writing and my cooking are, that's my heart. Mm-hmm. So if I am involved with you, and I really am beginning to feel like I want to let you know how I feel, then I will make you a banana pudding. I will make you some chicken soup. I will make you some baked turkey wings. I will be
fat fucking with you. My stomach is already big. I didn't gain too much fucking weight.
And so those are the things that I do. I may sit down and I may write you a 2 or 3 page, not letter, but 2 or 3 page booklet or something to let you know that I see that you are working really hard to do certain things. So these are some, maybe 1 or 2 Bible verses, but then these are some quotes and some words of encouragement for you. So, and in doing that, I'm doing a couple of things. I'm encouraging you. It's personal. It's from my heart. I didn't, and there's nothing wrong with going out and buying, but it's from my heart. And I'm also letting you know the standard that I want from you, okay? Not so much, I'm not asking you to get in the kitchen and cook, but you know that it doesn't take a whole lot
for
me. Yeah,
they can't do that. I cook too damn much. They can't do that to me.
Okay. So oxtail soup?
I cook too damn much. Huh?
Oxtail soup?
If you come in and cook for me, I would think it's a trick because I'm not used to it.
See, that's why you don't have a wife, baby. So at some point, you've got to ease the guard a little bit.
No, the guard can get let down, but my love language to me is your time.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I shouldn't have to ask for it.
Okay, that's fine. But in that time, we have to do certain things.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so if it's your time and I'm cooking, you could be in the kitchen with me while I'm cooking for you. If you're not going to give me an opportunity to show my love for you, then that's all one-sided.
Oh, I give opportunities. I give big opportunities, but they always fucking blowing it.
Hey, I know you're the host and all that, but I didn't see that this is like Get the Host Hitch show. We talking about healthy relationships.
Not the day just form in, you know. Part of the host is the healthy shit. I'm just saying because I'm just saying like it's the time, you know. What's your love language?
What's yours?
So, because that shit swung around to me. I didn't want to. But it got to me anyway.
So according to the authors that preach this, there's five love languages. Mm-hmm. There's words of affirmation. Mm-hmm. There's gifts. There's acts of service, quality time, and physical touch.
Mm-hmm.
I personally deal with the physical touch, words of affirmation, and gifts are probably my three big ones. But I work with them all, mm-hmm. honestly.
Yeah, we all do. Yeah.
And I think man's getting this gift and acts of services, like, for instance, where my wife and I went to the dealership recently, a couple of months. It ain't been a year yet, I don't think. And I went there, and I saw this Range Rover I was going to buy, and so I was in there working out the deal with the guy. So me and him went back to the office. I knew I bought one from him 10 years ago. I had bought a white Range from him a long time ago for my wife, and so she had a BMW X5, and so we go in the back and work a deal out. When I come out, you know, he's giving me the keys and he's asking for her keys and asking for the plates. And she looked at me like, what are you talking about? What do you want my keys, my plate for? Oh, I just bought two of them Range Rovers. We got you one too. She didn't have no idea. She didn't ask for it.
Uh-huh.
Like today, I'm going to go ahead and get it up. Husband time in right now. See, I brought her T-shirt. It's her new clothing line. It's called Corbella. She has a new online store.
Okay.
And I said, honey, give me a T-shirt. She said, for what? Just give me a T-shirt. She didn't ask. She didn't ask me.
Mm-hmm.
I thought about just promoting mm-hmm. her stuff, promoting mm-hmm. her.
Like Luther said, I thought about
it. Yeah, I thought about mm-hmm. you. So I'm promoting her line, her new own store line. She didn't have to ask me. She don't have to ask me for anything. That's how I move. Now, sometimes I get upset because I don't get that. I'll just get that back. Because that's not her love language.
That's it.
That's mm-hmm. not her love language. Mm-hmm. So sometimes I can't handle that. And okay. I'm keeping it real now, right? Sometimes I get upset and I have to realize.
Do you let her know?
I cannot. Oh, yeah. Okay. I cannot make somebody be who I am. Right, so it don't always, but she's learning to grow in those areas, you know. But she just moved differently, and that's okay. She who she is.
Mm, I love Luther.
What? Tell us about dreams are sexy.
Well, the idea is that I've done online dating. I'm a big advocate of. Just cut through the BS.
How'd it go?
I'll walk up to somebody and say, hey, my name's so-and-so. I really think you're attractive. Or what's your name? Uh-huh. Like, you know, this beating around the bush thing, I ain't got time for that. So, but my biggest thing about it is, tell me what your dreams are. Tell me what you're going. Where are we going here? Because, I mean, at the end of the day, if all you want to do is hang out, then maybe we're not a good fit for each other.
Because time is.
Because I got plans. I go traveling. I'm a big traveler, and I'm always putting my stirring the pot somewhere. So if you're not doing that either, and you're just your goal is just to like watch some TV, then we're not gonna work. So to me, intelligence, dreams, that's sexy.
Uh-huh.
Because in 20 years from now,
uh-huh.
That's pretty smart.
Because I think everybody here has something. Everybody here is part of a healthy relationship is their own.
Uh-huh.
Everybody here is different.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's for sure.
And I'm going to say this, being a married man, been married for 20 years. Man, I've been with her for about 23 years. And we had some ups and downs. But I can tell you that my wife and I are troopers because we have understood our commitment we made in the vows. And we have not let the world or even our own issues break what we made a promise to. We work it out. And it takes work. Listen, it takes work. People look at us and say, oh, that's the sweetest couple because she's nice looking. I'm decent ugly, you know. And we work it out. She's attracted to me.
Hold on. Hit the nail on the head.
Thank you.
This motherfucker said he decent ugly. Well, I never heard of that shit.
Please fix it.
Well, what I heard him say is they make it happen. That's why they call it making love, because you got to make it happen.
Yeah. We work it out. We work it out. We put work into it. I actively work on her. She works on me. And so for anybody that's looking for a marriage, and you're looking for an easy way out, I don't care how she look, how hard you look, you're going to have to put some work into this thing. Period.
Absolutely.
We had to work for it. Work. Friends come at you, family be involved, your own issues. You're going to have to work on it and stick in it. Because anybody you go get with, the next person is going to be the same thing. Same thing.
I'm going to let DL be my agent.
I'm already too many people's agent. Get in line.
You said something that's very important that we did not talk about, and that is that you have to keep other people out of it.
Oh, big time.
All right, if it's between you and I, it doesn't matter. I have seen, and maybe we all have, I don't know, but I certainly have, couples and families break up and have major problems, major separations over what somebody else told them, somebody outside told them that somebody in the house said. Mm-hmm. And that is so wrong, and you just can't do that.
Mm-hmm. Well, you got to put your earmuffs on when it comes to that kind mm-hmm. of stuff, because people want to put their two cents in all mm-hmm. the time, because if they're meddling with what you got going on, then they don't have to worry about what they got going on.
Or whatever, there's no mirror there.
Yeah, and it could be too much, and it could end up being tragic. It was a story happened just last week. The young lady got killed. The guy who killed his girlfriend and killed himself. It happened because they both had an outside relationship that was inappropriate, and then they made up. He goes out of town with some other female in the airport. One of her friends was there, saw him with the girl, took a picture of them, sent it to her. She calls him and dumps him. He goes back over there and kills himself and kill her. See, now the person took that picture.
You
need to sit down.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And mind your business. You never know what happens with that. Mind your business.
Yes.
Stay out of people's business.
Stay out of it.
And that's something else to part of healthy relationships, because, look, you can't be out there with somebody bullshitting. Because this shit right here
mm-hmm.
will get you caught up.
It will.
But see, that's quick. Dealing with the commitment. If you have a certain level of commitment, then you're not going to be doing that.
And you also have to look at what you don't know. I was in a relationship with someone, and one of my former coworkers called me and said, "Dorma, I see your man here, and he's sitting in a booth with another woman. You need to call him on his cell phone and tell him you know he's here." I said, "No." Mm-hmm. She said, "First of all, I don't know the situation, and evidently it doesn't involve me because I wasn't invited. Well, I need, no, don't you say anything. You need to." Well, it turns out that a couple of weeks later, he and I were talking, and he says, "Oh, by the way, you said that you wanted to meet so-and-so." "Yeah. Well, I know somebody who knows that person, and we met a couple of weeks ago for dinner. So anytime you want to have that meeting, let me know." He was taking care of business on his behalf and my behalf. What right would I have to go and step in? If you don't know the situation, mm-mm.
That's why trust.
Keep
trust
my,
is
trust,
everything.
I mean,
and
trust
you trust that he's not working in deception.
No.
That's it.
No.
That's it. No. I mean, I got my nickname Distant Lover because I was in a long-term relationship, and there was a lot of distance.
Oh, that's what DL means?
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah. And it just stuck. And I was doing a lot of traveling at the time, and so were they. And I love Marvin Gaye, and so DJ Distant Lover happened. You know?
Oh,
and
wow.
That's how it is. But I love double entendres, so DL is hilarious.
Oh, that's funny. That's something you probably would have gave my ass.
But, you know, long-distance relationship, that could be a healthy relationship, too. Open relationships, hey, at the end of the day, if you're happy and have trusted communication, more power to you.
Uh-huh.
Whatever it looks like, uh-huh. It's up to those people to define it.
Absolutely.
Not for everybody else pointing the finger.
No. Mm-hmm. Yeah. No, I agree. You're absolutely right. Yes.
Well,
look at me.
Because you're the host.
I stopped talking because DL got on me. DL got on me on my own shit. Like, hey, this was a fucking advertisement for the scene.
Hey, we got to announce the number here.
We love you.
We love you. You know what? You know what? Y'all wouldn't be able to love me if I didn't love myself.
This is true.
The host needs dates. Call 248-579-5295.
Get them hit.
Quality women up to make sure they can see it.
The show over.
Right.
Almost over.
Yeah, quality women, right?
Oh, man. I just need quality time.
Quality breeds quality.
Well, don't say that because, you know, you can get what you just said.
I can't get it. I haven't got it.
No, you can get someone to spend quality time with you who's not a quality person. Yes,
you can. But that's what's been happening.
But that's what's been happening. Yes, so you know,
DL going to know because I'm going to start getting on his damn
nerve. So you are a 28 karat gold man.
I'm going to start calling DL on the phone like, hey, DL, this is the shit that going DL.
I got thick skin, man. I got thick skin.
Oh, yeah. I called DL with a whole lot of shit. That's how me and Fine Star got close. He already know me. Uh-huh. And I say shit that even I know that's going to embarrass me. I don't care.
Oh, I'm incapable.
I feel too fucking good about myself and where I've been and where I come from. And he know me for that. She know me that. She getting to know more of me. Mm-hmm. DL, you next.
Ooh.
My new friend next. she's gonna get on her nerve.
Yes,
I call and get on her nerve. But
that's okay.
I just,
you
know.
I'll put you in my next book.
This is some of the things that people need to know about healthy relationships. They think they know, but they don't know.
But it starts with you.
Well, that's the thing, too. Mm-hmm. Don't be afraid to say, I don't know, or question. Questions are wonderful. Ask them.
Yes, very much so. And watch everything. Not like, you know, let me see your phone or where were you. But just watch them, you know, and watch how they act and how they are. If you have a son who needs you at a different level than the average person, and you don't give that son that additional time and attention and love and care, I don't want you. Because if you don't give it to your own flesh and blood, I know I'm not going to get it.
Right.
Yeah. Same thing with, you know, to me with God. People don't honor God in life. You ain't got no chance in hell, period. You know, it won't give you a liver and the spleen and the mind. People don't honor God, they can't be with me. They can't be that close to me. So I don't trust you. I didn't trust myself before I got to know God. So I'll say also that relationship, all of them takes work. Family,
very much so.
Each person that you choose to deal with in life, you got to become vulnerable. You got to come out there. You also got
to. I heard you say that.
You got to protect yourself as well. So you got to kind of know how to scale and make that, you know, even that thing up to become friendly, but not. Don't put yourself out there to be, you know, going to the same garbage can. You have to know how to switch up where you're going to eat at. If you see that's not working for you.
Don't be afraid to draw lines in the sand either.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. Said something like that the last show, though, about you got to be able to put yourself out there.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And you got to be able to deal with whatever come back.
But then also, you have to have somebody that accepts you, too. You cannot settle for somebody who doesn't accept you for exactly who you are.
Yes.
Because you're not going to change.
No.
Remember the conversation we just had? And this guy was trying to tell me, he was like, well, why do you say things that way? You shouldn't talk that way. Well, you know what? If you can't accept the way I'm talking, you can never be with me.
And
because
you
this is who I am.
Absolutely.
Right. And when you hold, I spend zero time concerned with my wife coming and going and what she's doing. I'm working on making us better. I'm working on building. I'm working on protection. I'm working on governing ourselves. I don't have time for the gutter thinking. I'm elevated.
Expanding,
I'm going up. So
you're working on expanding.
That's right. I'm doing things to make us better. I don't have time for all that foolishness, bringing in evil thoughts into your relationship, into your household. I don't even get involved with that at all.
But zero. Protect your peace.
That's important.
Stay off the seven deadly sins. That's
protect
it.
Protect your peace. I always say that you have to protect your peace.
Yes. I was very fortunate in that as my parents' lives drew to a close, I was the guardian and the power of attorney and all of that. But I had some aspects of it. I had to create healthy relationships with them, but I did it, and we had to get rid of a lot of stuff and a lot of. Well, I didn't know you felt like. Yeah. Well, I didn't know you felt that way. Yeah, so.
Right. Okay. So this shit went by too fast.
It went by too fast. Because DL, what did you say? It's not
about his relationship.
But you know what? It flowed into that.
It flowed.
Don't get me started because I'm fucking too single for this shit. But you know what? I like to thank our guest,
Dorma. Magruder.
Magruder.
Pastor Mo. Maurice Elhardwick.
Don't forget the AKAs.
AKA the street sweeper, AKA the street preacher, AKA my brother and sister's keeper. What up, though?
Right. Everybody in the hood got like 4 or 5 nicknames. That's what
I'm one. But he gave me one, Black yep. Elvis.
I heard Shoe. Wow. I was like, Shoe is what?
Now, if you look at Cassini, don't you like they might give a Black Elvis. You look at the profile.
He just called me Black Elvis back in high school.
Carl Perkins?
I don't even know who that is, but it don't sound good.
he wrote the tunes that Elvis
did. DL, my co-host. I like to thank Detroit Podcast.
What's my name?
5-star.
Okay, wow. But you didn't say that. You didn't say that.
Everybody knows she's on every show.
Doesn't matter. We like eventually. To be personified.
Oh, thank you, Randy. I got my seal on. I clap like a seal, but you know what?
I
appreciate y'all showing up.
Well,
I really
thank
do.
You
I appreciate.
I appreciate you having me.
I appreciate,
you, having
oh, me. I appreciate you. You know, this was a really thank good you. Conversation. Really, really. And I enjoyed y'all. And I love y'all coming here, especially DL coming back for a second time. Randy for always dealing with me and dealing with, you know, I text his ass all the time, shit by shit. Well,
and don't forget to subscribe.
Don't forget. That's what you're supposed to do as a co-host.
But you didn't give a name. All you said was co-host.
That's hey. Right.
Figure out your
that's
love language.
Yeah, figure out your love language. Understand healthy relationships. And comments, leave them on the third quarter Facebook page. Topics, anything y'all would like to talk about, get in touch with me, please. And we will see you again in 2 weeks. Thank you again. We out.
Peace.